Well, speaking of remnant theology, our last question's from Greg. In Acts 13, you briefly discussed Old Testament remnant theology and how it fits into the predestination election debate. He would love to hear more on this, the Old Testament idea, not so much how it fits in the New Testament, and also appreciate any resources you could suggest on this topic.
Yeah, there are a couple things that I will make sure Trey has, and Trey will make sure gets up on the website to deal with remnant theology, a couple articles. So you could look for those. I think to sort of try to summarize an answer here, remnant theology in the Old Testament, and sort of broadly speaking, is that God will never, he'll never let his plan for a kingdom die entirely. And therefore, he will never let his people be entirely exterminated by evil. He's not going to let evil win. Even so, as bad as it gets, it's never as bad as that, because God will intervene. He'll intervene when needed, but he won't eradicate evil, because that would mean eradicating humanity. He will not get rid of evil and free will, because then, you know, that's an admission. That would be an admission on God's part that, you know what, this was just a bad idea. You know, God's not going to do that. He is committed to humanity. He loves the idea of humanity. He created humanity to be like himself, which includes, again, communicable attributes, one of which is freedom. These are, on the surface, these are just the most obvious things theologically in the world that just jump out at you from the text. I think we need to affirm, you know, what's there in the text, and then, you know, come up with our best understanding of how to handle it. And sometimes, you know, people, like I said, just get married to systems, someone's attempt, and then, you know, love it so much that they'll defend it at all costs, even if one of the costs is coherence. But remnant theology, again, is just this idea that God is not going to let this thing die, and if he needs to intervene, he will. And he does that in the Old Testament. Noah, I mean, he doesn't wipe everybody out. He saves Noah. Noah finds grace in the eyes of the Lord. He saves Noah and his family. You know, he does it with his people. He does it with the tribes of Israel. You know, there's 700 who have not bowed the knee to Baal. He uses Obadiah to hide them. He's never going to let the thing die. But he will not, again, erase humanity to get it done. He will not erase the image to get it done. He has chosen to use people, and use people he will. There is no plan B. There is only plan A. And the New Testament, you have God acting to ensure, really consistent with the old, he's going to act to ensure that a remnant of believing Israel, the true Israel, will not be exterminated. You know, that he's not going to just going to forever forget the Jews now, and the Jews can all be exterminated and whatnot. No, that they are going to, they're going to be believers among the tribes of Israel, who embrace the Messiah, their Messiah, and become part of the people of God. But there will also be Gentiles. There'll also be people among the nations who are not of the 12 tribes of Israel. And he is going to lay claim to those nations as well as his own through them. He's going to make sure, again, that he's going to preserve a remnant. He's going to make sure that there are people from the nations, you know, who embrace the gospel and you know, that it never dies. You know, it never, there's never a single nation that doesn't have a witness. There's never a single nation that doesn't have God's people in it, infiltrating it to, again, multiply that situation, to take the gospel to every nation, to every corner, you know, of the world, and get the job done. You know, if God needs to intervene, he will. He will not let it die. So that's essentially the overarching idea of remnant theology. You know, by just think about what the New Testament is. You have the people of God. It's circumcision neutral. It's the tribes plus the non-tribes. It goes all the way back again. We're trying to restore an Edenic vision, God's rule over the entire planet. And originally there were no nations. There was no Israel, but now there are. But the plan is the same. You know, God is going to win, you know, the whole planet. You know, it's his. There's not going to be this little crack or crevice of it, or little portion of it, that he does not own at the end. And his vehicle for doing that are believers, they're people. And he's just not going to let it die anywhere, at any point.